Hello. Hi. How you doing? I'm Pat Glover, and if you stumbled upon this video, that means you're interested in getting into cybersecurity. Now, before we begin, I just want to give a big thanks for tuning into this channel, and if you like the content, don't forget to hit subscribe and smash the like button. This video could have gone a multitude of directions, and I think for the purposes of keeping it consistent and in an orderly fashion, and to be honest, there may be multiple videos on this topic, I wanted to focus on three specific things. The first thing being having some sort of technical background before getting into cybersecurity. Now, whatever that is, all you need to do is have a general understanding of information technology. Now, what I mean by information technology is how computers work, maybe how networks work, what the importance of a switch or a router, VLAN, things like that. If you know these terms and how they interact with one another and how computers and machines in general communicate across a network, that should be a good basis for you to get into the cybersecurity space. Now, before diving too far in, right, the idea of cybersecurity in and of itself is the practice of protecting systems, networks, and programs from digital attacks, right? So it would make sense that you have an understanding of these things I just mentioned in order to protect them from digital attacks, i.e. cybersecurity. Now, you don't have to have a super strong technical background. To be honest, there are roles within cybersecurity that don't necessarily require a technical background at all. Yeah, you have to be able to use a computer, but this day and age, I'd like to think that's pretty easy. Now, but for all intensive purposes in what I am describing here, it is important to have these key technical IT fundamentals. I think the best way to get those, and there's plenty of other people that will preach this, the best way to get those is through certifications or through a IT background at a university. Now, if you're already past that point, you have a degree, you're wanting to switch careers, that's fine. You can do this on your own through self-study, using a training program, or getting a full-blown technical certification. Two biggest technical certifications I would recommend are the CompTIA A+ certification and the Network Plus certification. Both are great entry-level certifications that will give you more than enough understanding and fundamentals of not only computer systems, but the network component of that through the Network Plus. And to be honest, once you get both of those, you're already two-thirds of the way there to being a certified security entry-level expert per the CompTIA Security Plus certification. It is a great entry-level certification, and I think anyone that is looking to get into the cybersecurity field fresh should work on studying for it and getting certified. Now, I took a different route coming from an IT background. I went from being a sysadmin and a network admin to then running my own security group within an organization. However, I did that by applying all of my knowledge and understanding of cybersecurity in those earlier years to then work my way up to a CISSP and now a CISM, among other things. So simply put, it's important to have some sort of foundational understanding of information technology. The next thing I want to discuss is kind of the key in this space, for my opinion, and that is passion. Like anything you do in life, you need to be passionate about it if you want it to continue long term, right? If you're not passionate about cybersecurity and you don't understand the level of interest and continuous learning and growth that is required of it, it can be a daunting process and you will burn out quickly. Now, I'm not saying that to discourage you. I'm simply saying that you need to be passionate about the subject because, like the IT space as a whole, cybersecurity is ever changing. There are always new things to learn within this space. With that being said, I'm not saying you need to go out there and learn everything about cybersecurity instantly. That is not what I'm saying. It is a baby steps process and you need to build your way up. The old mantra, do not postpone progress in pursuit of perfection, right? You're never gonna be 100% knowledgeable in the cybersecurity space and you don't need to intend to know everything. I think you just need to continuously have the desire to learn and put one step in front of the other to progress your knowledge and your skills. The third thing, and this may come as a bit of a surprise, is communication. Now, unless you're an ethical hacker and you get the opportunity to work by yourself with your face in front of a computer screen, in the weeds, day after day, and you can get this done without having to communicate with anyone, good for you. Almost every other role in cybersecurity is going to require some level of communication with others. You need to be good at communicating vulnerabilities, projects, exploits, whatever it is, you need to be able to effectively communicate these types of things with others in a team setting, right? A security team is not typically going to be one person. You're going to have a managerial role, most likely a CISO. You're going to have security analysts. You're going to have security architects. You're going to have security engineers. You're going to have program managers. If you're in an organization that can accommodate something like this, there are a multitude of people and personalities that you will need to be able to work with, and almost all of them in some way or another communicate with each other to effectively protect your computer systems, your organization, your networks, right? You're defending the confidentiality, integrity, and availability of the systems that you are hired to work for. So, with that being said, communication is key. Now, I'm not saying if you're not the best at talking in front of people, you can't do cybersecurity, because that's far from the truth. I am awful at speaking in front of people. Much to my chagrin, I've had to do it plenty of times, and you know, I get by. That is not what I'm saying in this situation. I am saying that you just need to have a general appetite to play with others. If you don't have that, there are still multiple routes you can go within the cybersecurity space. Awesome. It's great. That's what I love about cybersecurity. That's what I love about IT. But at a high level, to fit in with an organization, you generally need to be able to communicate with others. Now, it was a bit quick, but we covered kind of the three things I wanted to focus on for the purposes of this video, right? Let's recap. Having a general IT fundamental understanding. We talked about getting an A+ certification, getting a Network Plus certification. Once you have those, you're well off to jump right into the Security Plus certification. If you do all three of those, you're already landing a job in the cybersecurity space. Now, once again, those are three things to focus on if you don't already have a technical background. If you already have a technical background and you're in the IT space already, or some field very similar, and you want to make a transition into cybersecurity, just start learning cybersecurity terms, start taking online courses in the cybersecurity space. The Security Plus certification studying is a great one. Heck, start studying for the CISSP. Take cyberary.it courses. It will put you well on the right path to landing a job in the cybersecurity space. Next, we talked about passion. Passion is important in everything you do. Without passion, you would burn out and lose interest in whatever you're working on. Stays the same for cybersecurity. Lastly, communication. Being able to communicate with others and work with others and explain all of the technical risks and whatever it may be within the cybersecurity space is important. So, I hope you found this information useful. I will be posting tons of other videos of the cybersecurity space. I'm Pat Glover. Thanks for stopping by the channel. Don't forget to hit a like and smash the subscribe button for me if you want to see more.